Let me tell you how to get free Twitch panels for your stream profile page. Hey, what's up nerds? Keon here with Nerd or Die, and today I'm gonna walk you through the masterclass to Twitch panels. And if you don't happen to have any Twitch panels of your own, don't worry, because Nerd or Die is providing you with the one-stop shop for everything panel related, including already created panels for you to have for free. In this video, we're going to cover the free panels I just mentioned, how easy it is to get started making your own panels with our custom panel creator, what Markdown is and how it can make the content under each panel stand out, and even give you a handful of examples and ideas to help you get started with. Now, before we get into this video, YouTube really likes it when I remind you guys to hit that subscribe button and notification bell so you'll always be notified when we have a new video out for you. It helps us and we help you. So let us help you and do the thing. And now, with the power invested in me by the Nerd or Die team and this page, I now pronounce you ready for me to guide you through the ultimate guide to Twitch panels and show you exactly how to become a Twitch panel master. To get to this page, simply go to nerdordie.com/panels. Really easy to remember, and the link will be in the description as well. Starting from the top of this page and working down, our first stop will be the free templates. In this section, you'll find an abundance of free panels we lovingly designed for you to take home for the low, low price of free. If all you're looking for is pre-made panels that spice up your down below area on Twitch, this area is your new best friend. I should have been a voiceover guy. Oh, okay. Anyway. Some of these packs include multiple colors, so the arcade pop panels, for example, come with three different color schemes for you to choose from, right out of the box. We're always adding more panel templates, so keep checking back here for more updates. Also, if you happen to check out and buy any full pack we offer, it will automatically include matching Twitch panels for that package. If you found a pack that you like, simply click on it and you'll be taken to the full pack page where you can download the free panels. And if you like some extra free stuff to go along with your first order of free stuff, you'll be happy to learn that some of the packs include extra freebies as well as the panels. For example, Glitch 2 includes stinger transitions as well. Odds are if you like the panel design, then you'll probably like the full pack design it comes from as well. So give those demo videos and images a look, and you can choose to upgrade to the full experience by using the dropdown on the right side here, or just take the free panels and run. It's that simple. Now, before you ask, yes, all these templates do include a PSD for you to be able to fully edit and customize these panels to your liking. If you don't have Photoshop, that's not a problem. There's a free website called photopea.com. We did a full video on editing your panels with that. Link will be in the description if I've piqued your interest. Continuing on our adventure down the page, next we have the Panel Maker app. As you can see, it has tons of options to choose from for customizing. There is a lot to experiment with here. We have four tabs to choose from the top: General, Effects, Color, and Positioning. Each one has its own set of values, text boxes, and sliders to play around with. Typing in the text content field here, you can see the live preview to the right will update in real time with the changes we've made, and this also works with every other option in the app. You can change the font family, font size, alignment, and style. There are tons of icons in the Nerd or Die icon picker menu, but you can choose to disable this or even upload your own custom icon. There's options to enable or disable icon shadows, as well as adjust the shadow angle. You can play around with the border width and radius here too, adding a nice border with the width slider, and making rounded corner panels with the radius slider. There is nothing on this panel you cannot change the color of, so this will allow you to get that color palette just right. And for those finishing touches, you can move the text and icon around in the positioning panel to get things sitting perfectly. One last thing to note, we will be adding even more designs in the app in the future, so be sure to follow us on Twitter or hop in our Discord to be kept in the loop on all the new updates. By this point, you should have your Twitch panels in hand, and you're probably thinking to yourself, well, now what? Well, if you keep scrolling down to the page, you'll find yourself at the section labeled, How do I add these to my Twitch profile page? It may come as second nature to some of you, but for those of you that are just getting started, let's do a quick look at adding a freshly obtained Twitch panel to your channel page. To add the Twitch panels to your page, start by launching the About Me section in your profile found at www.twitch.tv/username/about. Now, don't actually go to twitch.tv/username. Instead, put your username in that area. Huh, I wonder if there's anyone actually named username on Twitch now. Anyway, toggle on the Edit Panels option and click the plus icon to create a new panel. Now either choose the text image panel or the extension panel, but for our example, we're adding a text image panel. You can name your panel up here, then we can click to add an image and select our freshly downloaded Twitch panels. You can even have the image we just uploaded linked to a different page, so if you have a support panel, it can link directly to your donation link. If there is any text you'd like to add, you can put it in the description box down here. And finally, click Submit to save the panel and toggle the Edit Panels option to off to view your panels. All right, now that we have the panel set up, let's back up for a second. Remember the description box? You might have noticed a little bit of text that said supports Markdown. So, what is Markdown? Well, it's essentially a way of formatting the text in your panel section. If you're going the extra mile to make your panels look great, you should absolutely be looking to format and stylize your panel section. If we scroll down here, you can see the input and output examples, where the input is the Markdown code you need to create all these stylized text sections on the right-hand side here. This section is a huge resource on formatting your Twitch channel's panel section. We've covered everything you could possibly need, and you don't need any HTML knowledge to do this. With Markdown, you can put text in bold, italicize, bold and italicize, make any text a link, make bold links, italicize links, bold and italicize links, create subheadings, bullet point lists, quotes with bold and italics, and you can even mix this all together. Ugh, that was a lot. The possibilities are endless, and you can just copy and paste this into your panels, which will let you chop and change to your heart's desire, allowing you to create beautiful panel sections that, quite frankly, look stunning. For those of you who want to dig into the nitty-gritty of Markdown, we've got you covered too. We go through text emphasis, lists, formatting, what each of these are, and when to use them, so you can fully understand the context behind each of these sections when used with Markdown. If for any reason you're struggling to think of what type of panels you might actually want on your page, we've put together this section to not only give you some ideas as a starting point, but to show you great examples of how other content creators have put their panel section together. From covering the simple things like an About Me panel, which covers a bit of information about who you are and what you enjoy, to the vast array of social media panels you can choose from, including Twitter panels, Discord panels, YouTube panels, and so much more. Here's some of the great examples we've seen from content creators on Twitch. This one by Mr. Boost shows a great addition of a Stream Elements extension, which you can grab in your panel section by browsing the available extensions for Twitch. We're not going to get too far into extensions today though, but we will be making an in-depth video about extensions somewhere down the line, so hit that subscribe button and notification bell so you know when that happens. Here we can see Future Man Gaming using a slightly larger panel image to show off his various channel badges, and a bit of nice Markdown for linking his tipping page. There are a lot of great examples here to pull inspiration from, and if you want to see their pages in more detail, we put their Twitch handles on each photo so you can go to their page and check them out in more detail. There are three basic types of panels: image, text, and extensions, as we previously mentioned. The examples above show all of these panel types in action, but this extra bit of information down here gives you a bit more context into what each one does and how you can utilize them effectively for your own channel. Below this is some 200 IQ knowledge, and best of all, it's brief and to the point, giving some useful food for thought on how you can use your panels and what you should aim for. But never forget, this isn't the end-all be-all 10 commandments for Twitch panels. Pirates of the Caribbean said it best. The code is more what you'd call guidelines than actual rules. Welcome aboard the Black Pearl, Miss Turner. I swear. Every time, Will says, "At least once more, Miss Swan," and then longingly calls, "Elizabeth." A piece of me dies. I mean, hey look, a segue! And that's it. The Nerd or Die Twitch Panels page is packed to the max with not just free assets, but is a powerful learning tool to give you both the materials and know-how you need to ascend to the next level of Twitch Panel Master. We appreciate you sticking around and checking this out, and if this video has taught you something, and you haven't already done so, hit that subscribe button and notification bell so you know when more useful information and tips are coming out! If you have any questions, comments, or concerns, feel free to leave a comment down below Or you can hop into our Discord, where we have lots of creative ideas, resources, and helpful support staff to keep you on the right track. You can also contact us via our contact page on nerderdie.com. Once again, I've been Keon with Nerderdie, and I'll catch you guys in the next one.